Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to welcome you to the 1998 Miss Hobbton Pageant. I would like to thank the entire faculty, students, and contestants for their many hours of hard work towards making this pageant a success. This is truly a unified effort from all involved. Special recognition is to be given to the pageant committee consisting of our director, Mrs. Hare, Mr. Perry, Mr. Bergenheim, Mr. Dent, and Mrs. Leinenweber, and many others who have spent extra time, also including Mrs. Brock, Mrs. Farmer, Mrs. Johnson and her second period English class, Mr. Morgan, Mrs. Nancy Heath, Mrs. Lowe, and her fourth period class, and also a special thanks to the many students recognized on the program. At this time, I would like to take a few minutes to recognize the special guests we have in the audience. If they would, please stand and be recognized. Members of our Board of Education, Mr. Billy Ray Daughtry and Mr. Russell Jones. I would like to introduce our superintendent for Sampson County Schools, Mr. Gary Weeks. I would also like for the following advisory board members to stand and be recognized, Mr. Joseph Barefoot, Mrs. Sue Britt, Mr. Bill Frederick, Ms. Sharon Herring, Mr. Dale McClam, Mr. Felton Rayner, Ms. Katie Rayner, Mr. Thomas Williford, Mr. Kenny Bass, and Mr. Wayne Thornton. We thank you for your continual support at Hobbton High School. Also this time I would like for the following parents to please stand and be recognized. Mr. and Mrs. Tommy Herring, the parents of our reigning Miss Hobbton Elizabeth Herring. Parents of our MCs tonight, Mr. and Mrs. Dan Bailey, and Mr. and Mrs. Paul Darden. And also I'd like for the parents of our six lovely contestants, if they would stand and be recognized at this time. We appreciate all the hard work they have done. We hope this night is to be enjoyed and wonderful all. At this time, I would like to recognize our distinguished Associate Principal, Mr. Reggie Pinkney, and his wife, Rose. And now I have the privilege of introducing to you our mistress, and master of ceremonies for tonight. Our mistress of ceremonies, Mrs. Elizabeth Suzanne Darn, is a senior, is the 18-year-old daughter of Paul and Faye Darn and Clay. Suzanne is Hobbton's 1997-98 homecoming queen, varsity cheerleader, member of the FBLA, foreign language club, debate club, science club, and has been nominated for Who's Who among American high school students. Upon graduating from Hobbton, Suzanne plans to attend Meredith College and major in nutrition and minor in dance. Brett Daniel Bailey, our master of ceremonies, is a senior, is an 18-year-old son of Mr. and Mrs. Dan and Kathy Bailey, graduated rank 3rd in his class, and is currently serving as FFA president, senior class secretary, FBLA secretary. He's a member of the FFA, FBLA, science club, debate club, vocational honor society, and the quiz bowl team. He was captain of our varsity football and is presently captain of our varsity baseball team. He's a Moorhead Scholarship nominee, recipient of the Dairy Leadership Award and the Tools for Tomorrow All-American Vocational Support Award. He's also attending Hugh O'Brien Youth Leadership Conference. Upon graduating from Hobbton High School, Brett plans to attend North Carolina State University major in agribusiness or economics. At this time, it is my privilege to turn the program over to Suzanne and Brett.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 1998 Miss Hobbton Pageant.
Here we are tonight, at the beginning of the century, in the world capital of elegance, refinement, and entertainment, Paris, the capital of France.
Would you accompany us on a breathtaking tour of the City of Light? Climb the 900-foot tower that's just been completed for the 1889 World Exposition. Cruise with us on the beautiful Seine River, having an encounter with Quasimodo in the famous Cathedral of Notre Dame. Sigh at the Mona Lisa at the famous French Museum, La Louvre.
And of course, shop on the Grand Boulevard.
Dine in one of the most refined restaurants, the Champs-Élysées.
And shop, I have always dreamed to buy one of those French feather boas. I've seen one.
Ooh la la, mon Suzanne, you absolument magnifique, your dress. Let me take you tonight to one of the most talked about establishments in all of Paris, Au Gay Paris, owned by my dear friend Simon.
But Brett, you promised to take me shopping on the shop at Essex.
Yes, sonny, will, but to Maine. Tonight, let's dine in wine. Have you ever had escargot?
No, can't
say. But snails, my dear, and pâté de foie, and canard à la France, and champagne.
Oh la la! No, Brett, I am not one of those can-can girls. Haven't you read the paper?
Don't let the media spoil our time. This is not Washington. Let me take you tonight to Beau Game Party. Have you ever had quiche Lorraine, salade vert, buff bourguignon, crêpe au cognac?
Très, monsieur, you have convinced me that tomorrow we will shop until we drop on the shop every day. Bonjour,
Ben. Bonjour. Voilà, Suzanne.
Bonjour. Let me take you to your seat.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Ah, oui. Since we last closed on this show, we have had no problems.
And are you putting on the skins in jail for tonight?
We had to. It was the only way to convince them that we were serious. From now on, Gay Paris shall be forever free as the can-can.
Should they be in?
So from now on, the only acts performed here will be the wholesome, respectful, and appropriate to the City of Paris.
C'est magnifique. You've done a wonderful job. You're impressive and stellar in the front.
It was my duty. Besides, once I made it clear that the can-can was not fit to be viewed, you'll be sure they will obey my orders.
Ah, vous êtes remarquable. How many times have you seen the can-can?
I have never seen the can-can. I will not sit for that type of repulsive entertainment.
You have not seen the can-can?
Never. I am a decent man. Oh, look here now. Here comes the next act.
Sure, you see.
Thank you.
you'll excuse me for 1 minute, I'm going to run and see if I can make a few phone calls and find out what the problem is, why they're stopping the can-can. I'll be right back. Thank you.
It gives me great pleasure to introduce our next act. She's traveled over 3,500 miles, I understand, to Paris. She has hits, R&B albums out, top 10. She's gonna sing one of her favorites from her latest album, titled What a Wonderful World, from Facing, North Carolina. I proudly present Cherie Stevens.
Thank you.
time. At this time, we would like to explain to you how Miss Hobbton is selected. Each girl is judged in four categories: interview, casual wear, talent, and evening gown. The girls have already completed the interview portion with the judges, in which each girl had to formally meet the judges. The other categories will be presented before the judges and you during the pageant.
The judges will score each girl on a basis of 1 to 10 in each category, but the number of points given in the category is multiplied by 2, which allows the talent category to account 40% of the total points. The winner will receive a cash scholarship, which will be awarded upon the Queen's enrollment into college, in addition to numerous gift certificates from area contributors. The crown for the new Miss Hobbton and for the future of Miss Hobbton is donated by our reigning queen, Miss Hobbton, Elizabeth Perry. In addition to a trophy, each contestant will receive a $25 certificate donated by Newton Grove Trust.
At this time, we would like to introduce our judges and auditors for this evening. Our chief judge tonight is Norman R. Atkins. Norman Atkins has been involved in pageantry for the past 14 years. He has been judging statewide for the past 10 years. Accredited as a judge by the Miss North Carolina and Miss America programs, and on the list of chief judges, Norman Atkins is employed by Duplin County's largest poultry firm as their corporate data processing manager. He resides in the Wallace area with his wife and their two children. Norman Atkins serves on the local advisory board for the elementary school. He coaches in the Parks and Recreation Department, and he also serves in the Boy Scouts of America as a Cub Scout leader. Our chief judge, Norman R. Atkins.
Judge number 2 is LaVoice Bond English. Mrs. English is a 1970 graduate of James Front Community College in the field of cosmetology. She has been the owner and operator of LaVoice's Beauty Salon for 28 years. She is also a beauty control image consultant. Mrs. English has been actively working with the Duplin County Pageant Association for over 16 years, serving in all phases. She is currently pageant president and is also business manager for Miss Duplin County, Miss Brandy Jordan. Mrs. English has judged numerous Miss North Carolina preliminaries, high school, and festival pageants. She served as a hostess for the Miss North Carolina pageant contestants for 7 years. Mrs. English is listed on the Miss North Carolina list of accredited chief judges. Mrs. LaVoice English is a bride of 33 years to the same man, Braxton English. They have 2 sons. Judge number 2, LaVoice Bond English.
Judge number 3, Susan B. Atkins. Susan Atkins has been involved in pageantry for the past 14 years. She has been judging statewide for the past 10 years. Accredited as a judge by the Miss North Carolina and Miss America programs, Susan Atkins is employed by Duplin County School System. She resides in the Wallace area with her husband and their 2 children. She is the mother of 2 wonderful children, Charlie, age 9, and Elizabeth, age 13. Elizabeth, her daughter, is the reigning junior team Miss Wilmington. Judge number 3, Susan Atkins.
Judge number 4 is Mrs. Liv Jenkins.
Liv Jenkins is a retired hairdresser and makeup artist. She is married to Lent Jenkins, and they have one son. Liv and Lent own Lent Jenkins Photography, specializing in pageant photography. Liv Jenkins has served as a PTA president and was Woman of the Year for Lake Rim Fire Department Ladies Auxiliary. She served on the board of directors for the North Carolina Arthritis Foundation and was named as National Volunteer of the Year. Liv Jenkins is a former member of the Miss Federal Pageant Association and served on the board of directors. She served as business manager for Kim Lucas, Miss Federal, 1996. Liv Jenkins has been on the list of accredited judges for the Miss North Carolina Pageant Association and has 29 years of experience in pageants as judge and director working in coaching. Judge number four, Liv Jenkins.
Judge number five is Lynn Jenkins of Fayetteville, North Carolina. Lance Jenkins is a professional photographer. He is married and has one son. He and his wife own Lance Jenkins Photography. Lance Jenkins is a former member of the Miss Fayetteville Pageant Association, and he has been on the list of accredited judges for the Miss North Carolina Pageant Association. Lance Jenkins was the official photographer of the Miss Fayetteville Pageant for 5 years, and he has over 20 years experience in pageants as judge, in production, and in coaching. Judge number five, Lent Jenkins.
We are also fortunate to have as our auditors tonight two of our own math teachers, Mrs. Sheila Jackson, and Mrs. Linda Pope.
Our first category this evening will be the casual wear competition. Each girl has chosen an ensemble to create her own picture of good taste and charm. The girl will be judged on charm, poise, graceful carriage, care and grooming, and personality. If the judges are ready, curtains please. Contestant number one, Christy Marie Warren. Christy is the 18-year-old daughter of Charles Fay Warren of Newton Grove. She enjoys dancing, water skiing with her family, and being involved in church youth group activities. Physics is Christy's favorite subject in school. Christy, an honor roll student and beta club member, is the varsity cheerleader, treasurer of the senior class, and a member of Future Homemakers of America, the Science Club, the Foreign Language Club, SAD, and the High School Concert Band. Christy was awarded fourth chair in all-county band this year and had perfect school attendance in 1994, 1995, and 1995-1996 school years. To attend North Carolina State University to pursue a degree in marketing and apparel management are Christy's plans after graduating from Hobbton. Voila! Contestant number one, Christy Marie Warren.
Diana Michelle Herring. Rex and Gail Herring are the parents of Michelle, who is 18 years old. Collecting coins, skiing, and horseback riding are activities that Michelle enjoys. Latin is her favorite school subject. Her school activities include cheerleading, being a member of the Beta Club, Science Club, Drama Club, HOSA, SGA, and the Prom Planning Committee. Michelle is also Vice President of her church youth group and Vice President of SGA. Awards earned by Michelle include the Latin One Award, the Health and PE Award, Track and the All-American Cheerleader Award. Michelle plans to attend Meredith College to obtain a bachelor's degree in psychology and then later pursue a degree in law. Voila! Contestant number two, Diana Michelle Perry.
Contestant number three, Tina Renee Underwood. Tina is the 17-year-old granddaughter of Tom and Carolyn Underwood. She enjoys cheerleading, dancing, drawing, playing the clarinet and piano, and talking on the phone. Tina, an honor roll student, is a member of the Science, Foreign Language, and Hosted Clubs, and is co-captain of the varsity cheerleading squad, Senior Class Vice President, and SGA Secretary. Awards earned by Tina include being nominated for Who's Who among American high school students, receiving the Carolina 1A Conference Academic Athletic Award, and being an all-county band participant. After graduating from Hobbton, Tina plans to attend Sampson Community College for 2 years and then transfer to East Carolina University to obtain a physician's assistant degree. Voila! Contestant number three, Tina Renee Underwood.
Club, Science Club, FBLA, and the Foreign Language Club.
Rebecca, an honor roll student, lettered in softball in 1996 and earned her softball hit in 1997. She has also received the Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Rebecca plans to attend the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill upon graduating from Hobbton High School, where she will major in education. Voila! Contestant number six, Rebecca Faye Hanson. This concludes the casual wear competition. Elizabeth Herring, the reigning Miss Thompson, is the daughter of Tommy and Sharon Herring of Beechen Grove. She will now be performing a tap routine to C'est toujours la même chanson. Please welcome the reigning Miss Thompson, Elizabeth Herring.
Since the printing of the program, these additional contributions have been made. Lydia's Total Hair Care System, $2 in Newton Grove, Patricia Williams Warren, and Michael B. Warren Electric of Newton Grove for a gift of money to us, the master and mistress of ceremonies. All of your support is greatly appreciated.
If you ever get a chance to go to Gay Paria, I hope you would take it. I was privileged several years ago to have the opportunity to travel over to France. It's a very beautiful country. The wine is excellent. The food is great. The art. One thing I found out was that Paris is a city of love. And I'd like to tell you a little experience I had while I was over there. To make it more like home, I'm even going to use my French accent that I learned while I was over there. So the experience goes like this. In 1992, I had the privilege to travel to France. Upon my arrival in Gay Paris, I found what I was looking for, which was love. I met this magnificent woman, Madame Bourgeois. It was immediate love at first sight. The only problem was She talked no English, and I talked no French. But I knew by her accents that she was in love with me. I enjoyed my stay over there. We went to the Louvre. We went to the Cathedral of Notre Dame. We visited the Arch Triumph, and everything was going great. Until one day, Madame Bourgeois came to me and said, "Monsieur Hobbs, I cannot see you no more." And I felt a sharp pain go into my heart. I said, "Why? Why can you not see me no more?" She said, "I have a case, some serious problems. It's called sinus problems." I said, "No, you mean sinus. You mean sinus problems." She said, "No, sinus problems. Sinus." I said, "Is this sinus problem contagious?" She said, "Yes." I started to worry. I said, "Is it fatal?" She said, "It possibly can be." I said, "What can I do?" She said, "You must leave Gay Perry immediately. You must get out of the country and never come back. I cannot see you." I said, "You must tell me a little bit more about this sinus problem. My heart hurts." I said, "Have you been to a doctor?" She said, "No, a doctor can't help." I said, tell me about the sinus problem." She said, "I've been trying to tell you I am a married woman and our husband has seen us."
Originality, performance, personality, and the ability to express themselves. These girls have worked very hard to perfect their talent. Christy Warren will now entertain us with a tap routine to Walking on Sunshine. Please welcome contestant number one, Christy Warren.
Thank you.
tap routine to Elvis Presley's version of Jailhouse Rock will be presented by our next contestant, Tina Underwood. Please welcome contestant number 3, Tina Underwood.
Now entertain us with a tap dance to Rudy's Rock. Please welcome contestant number 4, Jennifer Bass.
Thank you.
Desiree German will now present a vocal solo to Since I Don't Have You. Please welcome contestant number 5, Desiree German.
Now perform a tap routine to Devil with the Blue Dress On. Please welcome contestant number 6, Rebecca Harris.
Come on.
concludes the talent competition. There will be a 10-minute intermission at this time. We ask that all visiting and former queens report backstage during intermission. Also, refreshments will be available in the cafeteria.
Come in, please. Now we would like for visiting queens to introduce themselves.
Ladies and gentlemen, I bring you warm greetings from Fayetteville, North Carolina, home of the Young Star Productions Pageant Association. Proudly sponsored by the Law Office of Attorney Mario M. White, my name is Tanisha Williams, and I'm your 1997 Miss Cumberland County and your newly crowned Miss North Carolina Valentine. Thank you.
And I'm currently a sophomore at East Carolina University, but I plan to of Santa McGree in Business Administration and concentration in marketing. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Sabrina West, and I was Miss Hobbton in 1994. A long time ago. I'm a junior at East Carolina University, and I am majoring in accounting and minoring in business administration. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Carol Connolly. I was in Hobbton in 1993. Graduated from Meredith College last May, and I'm living in Raleigh where I work with Margaret.
Elizabeth Herrig will entertain us again as she taps to dance and feel it. Please welcome Elizabeth Herrig. Thank you. final competitive category this evening is the evening gown competition. The contestants will be judged on the same characteristics as the casual wear competition. If the judges are ready, curtains please. Contestant number one. If Christy had the opportunity to spend 1 week in Paris, she would like to visit the famous Eiffel Tower, the magnificent Cathedral of Notre Dame, and the Louvre. She would also like to see Mona Lisa and visit the shop to view firsthand various designer jewelry, perfume, and clothing. How exciting it would also be to Christy to enjoy the sidewalk cafe. Christy's most embarrassing moment occurred when she was 14 while taking driver's education. She was driving on Highway 117 and failed to see a road construction sign. She continued driving onto an unpaved section, and the driving instructor immediately yelled, "What are you doing?" Needless to say, Christy is now more observant of road signs. Contestant number one, Christy Warren. Contestant number three. If Tenny could spend 1 week in Paris, she would start off her week by visiting her Aunt Odile's family and inviting them to go with her to shop, shop, and shop. Of course, she would take her grandmother along for more reasons than just money. In addition to shopping, Tenny would spend 12 or more hours a day experimenting with various foods because she loves to eat. One particular appetizer she would like to try is escargot and garlic butter sauce with a side order of pickles. The happiest moment in Tina's life was when she went to live with her grandparents when she was 5 years old. She further adds that they have done a wonderful job in raising her and that she is so thankful for the kindness and love they have shown. Contestant number three, Tina Underwood.
Would have
have enough money to purchase at least an ounce of perfume for her mom. Eating at a sidewalk cafe, tasting French pastries and various cheeses would complete Jennifer's plans for her Parisian visit. Jennifer's most embarrassing moment occurred during her last pep rally. While attempting to do a stunt, she jumped onto my shoulders and almost fell forward onto Elizabeth. What a way to end your cheerleading career. Contestant number four, Jennifer Fast.
Contestant number five. While in Paris, Desiree would plan to visit the Comédie Française, Paris's most famous theater, as well as the opera. She would also like to visit some of the famous buildings in Paris, such as the Eiffel Tower, the famous Louvre Palace, and the Cathedral of Notre Dame. Finally, Desiree would simply enjoy roaming the mysterious streets of Paris, where she would visit the beautiful parks and enjoy a delicious French meal at a sidewalk cafe. The most embarrassing moment in Desiree's life was when she was thrown into a trash can by two upperclassmen during her freshman year. This incident was worse when the trash can overturned with her in it. She and the trash came tumbling over. Contestant number five, Desiree German.
Yeah.
bien, merci. Et vous?
Très bien. I am so pleased that you are finally coming to see a performance of the Cancan.
You are most welcome. Do not forget that this is a trial. If I am not convinced that this performance is not good for the people, then this will be the final Cancan.
Ah, you said that now, but I know you will be convinced.
We will see.
I have every confidence.
We will see.
Right this way. Well, you must excuse them all. Mesdames and Messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, tonight will be a history event. For as many of you know, it is in his honored hands the future of the famous Can-Can. For we believe that tonight you will be witness to a great event. No more secret performance of our beloved dance. For after tonight, we hope to have the blessing of his honor and be free to do the Can-Can dance anytime. So, without further ado, voila! The Can-Can!
Thank you.
Miss Hobbton, Elizabeth Herring, is a cheerleader, treasurer of the junior class, and is a member of the softball team. She's a member of the Beta Club and a principal's list student. This past summer, she attended legislative school and SASE camp. Please welcome our reigning Miss Hobbton, Elizabeth Davis Herring, as she presents her farewell.
Peas and carrots, and not let anything tear us apart. Daddy, I think you're the best role model anyone could have. You're good at everything you do, and you have taught me through practice I can achieve anything. Last, and definitely not least, I owe the biggest thanks to my mom. Nobody knows all the hard work and time you put into helping me with the pageant. And without you, S. Dawg, I wouldn't have the confidence I have today. Mom and Daddy, I will always be your little girl. It has really been a great honor representing the number one school in the county. Throughout my reign, I have run in various parades and represented Hobbton High School at Pageant. I also participated in homecoming, and I would like to thank Mr. Beaton for escorting me and Jonathan for driving me. I really believe the students and faculty of Hobbton High School are the best. To the next Ms. Hobbton, congratulations. Wear your crown proudly, and I would like to say to the contestants, you have all done a wonderful job. Before I conclude, I want to say thank you, God, because without you, I wouldn't be here today. And it is with that mighty wildcat cry I say for the last time, I am Elizabeth Harry, Miss Hobbton, 1997.
Treasure Lake Contestants. Curtains, please. Thank you.
be surprised how much good stuff there is around here.
The law must be tempered with reason. Should be considered treason when love comes in and takes you for a spin. Ooh la la la, c'est magnifique. When every night your loved one holds you tight. Ooh la la la, c'est magnifique. But when one day your loved one drifts away. Ooh la la la, it is so tragic. But when once more she whispers je t'adore, c'est magnifique. But when one day your loved one drifts away, ooh la la la, it is so tragic.
We've all been waiting for. One of the girls backstage will be crowned Miss Hobbton 1998 in a matter of moments. If the contestants are ready, curtains please.
The first award tonight is the most talented non-finalist award. This award is given to the girl or girls who are non-finalists, but received the most points in the talent category. The most talented non-finalist is contestant number 3, Tina Underwood.
The next award given is the Miss Congeniality Award. This is a very special award because the girls themselves voted for the friendliest, most helpful girl during the pageant. Miss Congeniality is contestant number 2, Michelle.
And now for the second runner-up. Second runner-up is contestant number 1, Christy Warren.
Her position. First runner-up is contestant number